Ah, you made it here in one piece. Welcome to the Untamed Wild. Name's Colton Locke, but everyone calls me Doc. I'm the warden up here, and I know just about every nook and cranny of this place. I heard this is your first time in the Pacific Northwest and Lake District. Well, this here's the best hunting reserve you'll find in 100 miles. I've been hunting here my whole life, and I still don't get tired of this place. Go ahead, look around. There's a lot to discover around here, not just the big game. Let's see what you can do. Try to find an animal track around here. If you want to get your bearings, there are lookout points spread out all over the reserve. There's no shortage of ways to earn money as a hunter. No shortage of ways to spend it either. There are times when you'll want to be moving fast out here, but not when on a hunt. The animals will hear you coming a mile away. Stay low when you're stalking an animal to avoid being seen. Use your binoculars to get a closer look. Be sure to aim for its vital organs. Heart and lung shots mean quicker kills, less painful. You hear that? Calls are really helpful when locating an animal. Would you look at that view? Never gets old, I'm telling you. From up here, you can see a lot of great hunting spots in the area. Valmont's not only where Hope set up camp, it's also famous for the railroad bridges along the old North Pacific line. Keep an eye out for them if you can in between blacktail hunting. Or why not use them as vantage points? I once bagged a whitetail from the Runaki Bridge. Be sure to stop by one of the outposts. You can find pretty much anything you need there. Hey, you're catching on quickly. Wow, these are some strong gusts today. I'll have to speak up, or you won't hear me. Gentle now. Take a deep breath to steady your aim. nice place, right? You won't find a soft bed in many parts around here. Don't forget to stock up before heading out. You know that guy I mentioned earlier, Hope? Well, looks like he's been having a bit of a problem lately. He's been camping out over at Balmont a couple weeks, but coming back last night, he found his camp turned on its head. Some food was taken, and apparently the place looked like it had been really messed with. I don't know if it was an animal or some tourist troublemakers, but I'm up in Topeka all day and can't look into it. Listen, I know you probably have other plans, but you're in the right neck of the woods, and I'd sure be grateful if you could just stop on by and have a look. Hope showed up here 2 years ago. Said something about getting off the grid. I heard he lost his family in an accident while he was deployed overseas in the army. Hit the poor guy hard. I guess out here you only need to look out for yourself. It's easier that way. Not the most cheerful fella, to be honest, but he's earned his peace for sure. Let's find out whoever did this. Thank you. It's bleeding, so that's a hit. Follow the blood trail to find it. Shouldn't have gone far. They're getting close. Hope mentioned seeing some tracks in the mud. See if you can find them. Found them? Great. Snap some pictures for the record and see if they lead anywhere. Definitely human. Looks like a troublemaker then. Now, I don't want you to go picking any fights, but maybe you could follow them and see where they lead. Some ripped clothing. And no more tracks, huh? Well, just leave it for now, and I'll see what I can come up with. This'll help, though. Thanks. ever need a place to rest, there's a cabin in each outpost. I had them gutted and redone last season. I'm still looking into that incident at Hope's camp. I spoke with him and he wanted me to pass on his thanks. He's been having some problems finding food lately, though. The black-tailed deer are surprisingly scarce in Valmont for this time of year. Now Hope seems to think some black bears are passing through and scaring off the blacktails. Could be true, but it's hard to know for sure. If you come by any bear tracks in Valmont, let me know. Blacktails are Hope's bread and butter. If you ever want hunting tips on him, he's your man. He's been with the blacktails for a while now. If they're on the move, it's not only a problem for Hope, it might mean worrying changes for other parts of the reserve. careful. The underbrush can be a bit noisy this time of year. If an animal hears you approaching, you better believe it'll turn tail and run. Or worse. Getting your feet moving, I see. Just remember to take a breather before shooting anything. No, I spotted some tracks earlier, close to where you're at right now. I'll send the coordinates. White-tailed deer are often slightly bigger than the blacktail, but they're quicker to flee if they sense danger. Sounds like Richard's gonna need a helping hand. Sorry, we got this full-blown survivalist fella living out here all year round. Richard Hope. He got in a bit of trouble, it seems. I can fill you in on the details later. look at that. Let's see if there are any additional signs of the black bears to support Hope's theory. I noticed you're after moose. Tough animals, I tell ya. Be sure to bring the right caliber weapon to bring them down. Oh, and while their eyesight ain't too good, their smell is. So keep your scent and the wind in mind. You'll find coyotes all over the reserve, so they're not the most difficult to hunt. They're pack animals, so they respond well to callers, but they can also get aggressive when alerted. So be careful. Guess that settles it. No wonder the blacktail's on the run. Gotta give Hope some credit. His suspicions were right on target. Thanks for keeping a lookout. Be careful when hunting black bear. Not only are they unpredictable, but they also make very little sound and leave few tracks. You can sneak up on one without realizing it. Fortunately, they'll probably notice you before you them, and will keep their distance. Hey there, I think it's time I told you about Jonathan Trampfine. He heard of your dealings with black bears in Belmont, so he wanted to know if you might help him out as well. Trampfine loves black bears. He's been living out here on the reserve for many years, getting as close as he can to the bears and documenting them. A little too close for comfort, if you ask me. Last couple of days, he's been trying to get a picture of a group of black bears that just arrived this season. He's had no luck, though, and he wondered if you would take a swing at it. He'd pay you, so it might be worth your trouble. I don't even know where to begin with Jonathan. He probably feels like he's becoming one with nature out here. And I can understand that, of course. But he's walking a fine line. And I worry one day he might find himself on the wrong side. You've probably come across a coyote by now. We have a sizable population in the reserve. But the wildlife varmint control are constantly trying to keep it in check. Fiona Voiles is their operator in the area, and she's your go-to when it comes to the coyotes in this region. They could use some help with the population control, and there's good money in it, too. She wanted me to let you know that Gila Pass has seen an increase in coyote sightings lately, and that they're offering a reward to anyone harvesting coyotes. I think you'll need a coyote collar for this one. black-tailed deer are one of the easiest animals in the reserve to hunt. Still, be wary of your noise and the wind direction, as their senses are quite good. Look at that. You found a shed. I've already got a big enough collection back home, so I've started selling any new ones I find. People often buy them for handicrafts, you know. Knife handles and such. I once sold a really nice moose antler for $500. If you want to stay busy on the road, I'd keep a lookout for sheds. You know, antlers that are shed by the reserve animals? They're rare to find, and very popular to collect. Ah, hunting Roosevelt elk, I see. Roosevelt's a big fella, but its good sense of smell and hearing make it tricky to hunt. keep track of where the wind is blowing. Animals will pick up your scent easily if they're downwind from you.